April 11, Thursday of the 5th week of Lent. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the Jews, "Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever keeps my word will never see death." So the Jews said to him, "Now we are sure that you are possessed. Abraham died, as did the prophets. Yet you say, 'Whoever keeps my word will never taste death.' Are you greater than our father Abraham who died, or the prophets who died? Who do you make yourself out to be?" Jesus answered, "If I glorify myself, my glory is worth nothing. But it is my Father who glorifies me, of whom you say, 'He is our God.' You do not know him, but I know him. And if I should say that I do not know him, I would be like you, a liar. But I do know him, and I keep his word. Abraham, your father, rejoiced to see my day. He saw it and was glad." So the Jews said to him, "You are not yet 50 years old and you have seen Abraham?" Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, before Abraham came to be, I am." So they picked up stones to throw at him, but Jesus hid and went out of the temple area. The Gospel of the Lord. "Now we are sure you are possessed." The Jews who have been hostile to Jesus are scandalized by what Jesus claims about his life-giving words. Jesus promises immortality to those who keep his words. Not only defined it outrageous, but diabolical. They accuse him of being possessed. The Jews base their arguments on Abraham. Is Jesus greater than Abraham who died? In effect, they are saying, "Who do you think you are?" Jesus is handling a very terrible conversation. Much earlier, the same question was asked but in a more polite manner by the Samaritan woman at the well. "Are you greater than our father Jacob?" Jesus stands by his claims. He does not chicken out for the sake of peace. Before Jesus, we believers cannot argue much against him. It is always we who are liars or ignorant or at fault, not Jesus. If we want eternal life, we better take him. We cannot go to heaven by any other means. We may not be arguing against Jesus or the Gospels, but we may have long abandoned him. We have become secularized, living without God in our agenda. We are possessed by our wealth and by people who give us comfort.